Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to today's presentation as part of your overall SWK Empower experience. Hope everyone's doing well. So today we're going to walk through just a quick high-level overview of CIMcloud as an e-commerce solution provider for Sage. And we're going to walk through just at a high level, kind of an overview of the organization and our product offering. And then we'll be doing an immediate session right after this to go through a little bit deeper dive in a demo environment, and then also hit any Q&A that came up during the presentation. So to give a face with a voice, my name is Jack Evans. I am an account executive over here at CIMcloud, and I work with prospective customers, so customers who have not yet onboarded at CIMcloud, and work with them to identify their requirements and put together a software infrastructure that aligns with those requirements. So again, working with resellers like SWK, I'm able to identify kind of what your objectives are, where and how CIMcloud as an online solution provider kind of fits into those requirements, and then get you into a product that fits those needs and aligns your business for success. So again, as a refresher, we will be doing a live Q&A afterward. If there's any questions that come up during my presentation, definitely advise you dropping those into the chat window. I will be monitoring during this portion of the presentation, and I'll either hit those in line or follow up and hit those after during the live Q&A session. So just a refresher there. And what you're seeing on screen here is today's agenda. So we're going to start by just talking about some of the shifts that we've seen across industries over the last 12 to 14 months, kind of related to COVID-19 and other external factors. I'm going to walk you through a pretty high-level overview of our solutions and what we can do to help businesses like yourself. Then we're going to hit some strategies for success, both with CIMcloud and independent of CIMcloud as you evaluate projects for your business to take on, either coming into 2021 or as you forecast projects out into the future. And like I said, we'll be doing a follow-up session immediately after. So I'm going to go ahead and dig in, and I'm not going to read slides to you or let you kind of decipher all this on your own. But really, when you look at industry reports and data over the last 12 to 14 months and kind of some trends that have been found, particularly in the B2B world, there's really, you can compartmentalize these statistics and others into three general areas that we've seen a lot of external shift here. So the first change, obviously, is changes to workforce structure and how your employees are both interacting with other employees as well as interacting with existing and prospective customers. That's also created a shift in the strategies that organizations are taking to sell into those customer groupings. And then ultimately, as you can probably imagine, that's driven hyper-growth in online selling tools, i.e. e-commerce, and ways to do business not only in remote environments, but also in an online environment, even for those employees once they've come back into the office. And same with customers on the purchasing side who are now hopefully going back into a typical or traditional business setting. So again, you can really bucket it as there's been changes in the workforce structure and the way that you do business with customers. That's changed the way that you need to interact with customers in a selling environment. And the easiest way to do that is via online solutions that give that remote access to both parties. As it relates to kind of where current B2B organizations are, and myself sitting in the seat I do at CIMcloud, I work with businesses across this spectrum. I would say typically I work with people that fit into one of the two middle columns, but I'm going to walk through all four and just give some context. There is a high likelihood, if not guarantee, that all of you on today's presentation fit into one of these buckets. So the first kind of grouping here are people who traditionally have not viewed e-commerce and online selling as a fit for their industry, for their business model, or their market. So it's just not been a fit for one reason or another. It may be customer sophistication. It may be a complexity in the sales process or complexity in the way that they interact and do business with customers. But again, the first grouping are people who have traditionally said e-commerce and online solutions are not a fit for my business and not a fit for my market. The second bucket here are people who have a corporate website, and this is very common. So you can find them online. If you do Google searches, you can find them on Google. But when you get there, it really just tells you a corporate kind of placeholder of here's who we are, here's what we do, here's the products or services we offer. But there's no ability for a customer to take that next step so they can find you. But as they want to reach out to become an established customer or get further information, they have to go into some sort of online form or pick up the phone and call or fill out a contact request form. So again, you have a website, which is a great first step, but it's not designed to be a part of your selling strategy as a business. The third bucket here are people who are leveraging e-commerce as a selling strategy, but maybe they're not doing it in the most sophisticated way possible. So this could be, and just kind of using myself as an example here, this may be somebody who has a direct-to-consumer site that's non-integrated, and so they're having to have heavy manual entry requirements, getting all of those direct-to-consumers from the website into the ERP system. Maybe this is a wholesale company who has a custom-built kind of back-end portal. And again, it's not integrated with their ERP system. It's not designed to be kind of fully intensive for customers, and therefore it requires either your team to do daily imports and exports to get information up to date. Again, it also creates that back-end bottleneck where orders are not seamlessly flowing into the ERP system. And it could even create problems where customers are seeing pricing that's not applicable. They're seeing order history that's only including online. So again, they're taking the right step towards moving into an e-commerce landscape and really driving into that final category. They're just not quite there yet. And the final category are your e-commerce leaders. And those are, again, the highest sophistication level customers. This is where I strive to get all the projects and organizations that I work with to. We want to get you from being a player in that e-commerce space or just having a website that has no selling strategy behind it into a fully integrated solution. It's become an extension of your selling organization. It's eliminating Q&A, inbound calls to your customer service team or emails to your customer service team. And it's not only a tool to attract new business, but it's also a way to build customer stickiness and drive away competitors. So again, pretty much everyone that I work with and everyone on today's presentation will fit into one of these four categories. So when we look at the CIMcloud platform, it's combined of B2B customer portals. And like you're seeing on screen here, these would be login protected where a B2B customer can come in. They can view the dashboard as you see on screen here. They can shop for products and view product catalogs. They can build out favorites lists. They can look at Sage data on frequently ordered products or recently ordered products, add items to cart in bulk, view past orders, both online and offline, view invoices, and ultimately pay those invoices and do account management type functionality. So again, B2B customer portals are at the heart of what we do. On the back end of that are the employee or CRM portals. It's kind of part of our all-in-one CIMcloud solution where your employees will have the same access to the same data coming over from Sage that your customers do. So we talked earlier about workforce structure shifting, remote employees, people needing to be able to do business kind of anywhere, anytime. And so again, part of our application is giving your employees that remote access that they need to get visibility into orders and invoices and customer activity, again, from a remote environment without having to directly interface with the ERP system. And then for those people who either have an outdated website, so they may be in that we have a website category, or they may be in the people who've never really viewed e-commerce as a fit for their business, we can also deploy public-facing websites that can be a corporate placeholder that tells who you are, what you do. It can also be a direct-to-consumer selling tool. So what you're seeing on screen here is a live customer of ours. This one actually is designed to be a selling tool, a direct-to-consumer selling tool. But if you just need to tell who you are, what you do, and then drive users into that B2B portal, we can obviously tackle that as well. So a bunch of different flavors for our product offering. As I alluded to earlier, really my role here is to dig in with clients, make sure we understand their requirements, and then make solution recommendations that will solve those pains and fit those requirements. And we'll get into a little bit more product information and the back end of today's call. If you'll enjoy us for that session afterward, I'll walk through a little bit deeper dive demo and hit any specific questions that we do have. So what you're seeing on screen here are strategies for success. And while these are designed specifically for CIMcloud, These really do fit across the board, particularly when you're thinking through customer-facing solutions. So whether that's e-commerce, whether that's some other business insights dashboard, again, they really all fall into these four categories that help you strive to a successful implementation of solutions. So the first step here is pursuing the project with alignment. As it relates to e-commerce, you want your organization to view the e-commerce asset as more than just a website, as more than just an additional way to do business. You want alignment across your sales, your finance, your leadership team, even operationally, where everybody views the site as a key value add and a key way to do business with customers. The second area that we want to focus on here is taking a phased approach. So we want to make sure that we're positioning ourselves for success, but by not biting off more than we can chew. So again, that might be a crawl, walk, run approach, or a phase one, phase two, phase three approach. But again, you want to make sure that you're giving yourself a realistic chance at success and not allocating too much work to your team and really driving out the time to value on these projects. The third bucket is obviously leveraging your ERP system. You'll hear that from me throughout the presentation today and afterward in any conversations we may have. Again, that ERP system is the backbone of your organization. It houses all of that business critical data. And we want to make sure that anything that customers are interacting with does see that accurate data. So their pricing, their order history, even their products. We want to make sure, again, that that user experience mimics the ERP data and mimics the experience they would get from your organization in person or over the phone. And then the final thing is probably the most important, but really focusing on adoption. So we can build the best solution possible, but if you don't drive adoption, it just becomes an expensive cost bucket. So again, you want to make sure that you're building a solution that fits customer demand, that fits the things that customers need to be able to do, and then incentivize them and train them and coach them on how to use the application and the value that the application drives back to them. So each of these are important. I would say that the final bucket there, really making sure you drive adoption, is the force that brings us all together. You want to pursue it with alignment. You want to take a phased approach. You want to leverage that business critical data. And then you want to get users on the platform and driving adoption and driving ROI. So like I said, that was more specific for CIMcloud. But again, across the board, when you're evaluating projects and solutions, those strategies for success are key and really do translate outside of just a CIMcloud environment. And then the last thing that I'm going to hit here is keys to success specifically with CIMcloud. So I work through clients or work with clients through these areas, and you're kind of seeing four bullets on screen, but the first step is understanding the process and the program that you're getting yourself into. So what are my objectives? Who do I have internally to fill the critical roles that will drive me towards those objectives and have clear milestones throughout the project? So again, we value or evaluate these initiatives as an overall program with different projects that drive towards that long-term vision. So you want to get connected, you want to focus on implementation, you really want to drive rollout and drive that adoption and then pivot into that ongoing support stage as a customer of CIMcloud. Previous slide, I mentioned critical roles that go into a project. What you're seeing here on screen are what we call key or critical roles or hats that need to be worn by people executing the implementation. And this could be internal for your organization. It could be a third-party vendor. It could be leaning on CIMcloud. But again, you want to make sure that you have people, and it doesn't need to be one person for each seat, but you need to have people that fill these roles, that understand their involvement and their role in the project, and have the capacity and domain expertise to execute. So again, this is something I work with on clients, is helping map out who's sitting in what seat and making sure we're positioning not only for solution success, but again, for implementation success and providing that horsepower needed to get fully live and fully adopted. And then the final thing there, and it really ties the previous two slides together, is making sure that we're providing clients with tools to drive implementation, to drive adoption. And so we have a help center. This covers everything from a pre-sales prospect that I'm working with all the way through live customers who are working through feature upgrades or migrations. And so again, this is a new tool that we've built out over the last year. It's our help center. and it is designed to be the one-stop shop for all things CIMcloud, regardless of where you are in the relationship and in the lifetime of working with us. And I can provide a lot greater detail on this if anyone wants to follow up with me individually. So that's really what I wanted to cover today. As I mentioned, we will be doing a session right after this to hit some Q&A, anything that wasn't covered in the chat window today, as well as a brief live demo and a little bit deeper dive on the product. So I really do appreciate everyone joining us. I look forward to talking momentarily in a live environment. And thanks again for your time. I know everyone out there is busy and really appreciate SWK for providing this environment for me to present. And like I said, look forward to talking to everybody in just a couple seconds.